Guys, welcome back to Ashley's Amphibians and Reptiles. Today, we are going to be going over the top 5 reptiles that can go in 18 by 18 by 24. So, if you're wondering who I'm holding right now, I'm holding Sheila. She's huge. She's getting big. She's almost a year old. She's doing really well. But let's get on with number 5, gargoyle geckos. Gargoyle geckos are a very, are you musking? They're a very cool, reptile, from the, it's a tiny, tiny little island, and it's the New Caledonia island, because it is a New Caledonia gecko. And the reason I am not saying a crested gecko would work the same as well. But a crested gecko, you see a crested gecko all the time. You do not see gargoyle geckos all the time. So you want something a little more unique? Gargoyle geckos are awesome. Gargoyle geckos eat a very good, amazing, easy diet. They just eat basically powder you mix with water, and then you put it in an enclosure. That's it. This isn't a care guide anyway. Do your own research on them. But gargoyle geckos are a nocturnal species of reptile, so you do not have to offer UVB, and you don't have to offer heat. I'm not saying nocturnal reptiles don't need heat. That's not what I'm saying. I'm just saying these guys don't need heat. You can offer them UVB, but you don't need to. I mean, all animals can benefit from UVB, as long as they have a place to get away from UVB. But they don't, it's not required for these guys. Oh, there's so many cool colors and morphs and patterns. My favorite is the Deadpool pattern. Actually, I like Deadpool because I don't. But it's because just how pretty they are. I love red animals. Red, orange, or blue animals are my favorite. And black and white. Those are my favorite types, colors of reptiles. Number 4. Amazon milk frog, and like Adam, I'm ruining the list for amphibian. The Amazon milk frog is an amazing frog. I have 2 that are not eating for some reason. I don't know what I'm doing, but they need to eat, so that's
assist feeding.
They are very, very amazing species of nocturnal tree frogs. Amazon milk frogs are super, super cool frogs that are blue.
Yo, listen up, here's the story about a little guy that lives in a blue.
Their blood's blue, their organs are blue, and they are such cool frogs. They almost remind me of a glass frog, except they're not transparent. But Amazon milk frogs, like I said, are nocturnal. I almost said reptiles. They're not reptiles, they're amphibians. If you want me to do, like, a difference video between reptiles and amphibians, leave a comment. I mean, it's pretty easy. But anyway, they are a tree frog in the Amazon in South America, and where you will find them in the Amazon is up in the canopy about, like, near the top of the trees. And they are beautiful. You can build beautiful paludarians, like I did video up there. So, very, very cool, cool frogs. And they're unique. You do not see an Amazon milk frog every day. Whatever. You be you, girl. But anyway, as I was saying, before I got rudely interrupted, they are beautiful, beautiful frogs, and Latin name Transilius refinesix, or Transilius, that's basically how you pronounce their name. Latin name, I don't know the Latin name for, that's the only one I know the Latin name for. You can make, like I said, beautiful paludariums for them, and they eat crickets, and that's pretty much it. That's all I offer them, but they do love a varied diet. You can house multiple Amazon milk frogs in the same enclosure, and you can even cohab day geckos with Amazon milk frogs. They are very social species of, I almost said reptile again, amphibian, I can make a video about it. They're very, very, they're a larger frog, a larger tree frog. Not as big as a white tree frog, but about the same size, a little smaller. But they are big frogs, which means big poop, and they love to spread their poop. They love making, like just painting with them, painting, and, you know, that painting, that kind of stuff. So they love doing that. So I would make sure, be prepared for there'd be a lot of poop and cleaning windows of glass. Amazon milk frogs can be picky eaters at times, but I think the best method that anybody should ever use is the cup method, which I have a video on. Just go watch it up there. Number 3, rough green snakes, or just the whole kind of green snake family. The green snakes, they're super, super cool snakes that live in America, North America, and they're a beautiful, beautiful green, and they eat on, they don't eat on a rodent diet like you see with, that's a huge fly. They don't eat a rodent diet like you see. King snakes, corn snakes, ball pythons, they do not eat a rodent diet. They eat bugs, which is super weird because you never see snakes eat bugs. You never see a snake eat bugs. So that's different about them, but it's a cool factor about them. These frogs you will not find at your local pet store, but you will find it at maybe Kijiji or Craigslist breeders, or even in, what's it called? Reptile expos. You will see them. Adam, 2024, come down. There's just a super, super cool, small green colubrid. They are vertically, they like vertical tanks, like this one, like, which is an 18 by 24. They like vertical tanks and enclosures, and they like big branches to climb on. Can give them a low heat light, which is basically maybe like a 70, not like 50 watt heat hotspot. You could do a light, halogen, something like that, and you could make, I would recommend a wood heat spot out of cork bark, so they can just sit right on top of the cork bark. And that's what I do with my Lake Chipola garter snakes. So they can live in an 18 by 18 by 24 inch enclosure, which is probably the only snake that can. Number 2, green-keeled belly lizards. I love these lizards so much. They're such cool lizards. They are often called mini monitors because they have the personality and all the characteristics of a monitor, but they're not a monitor. They are a super cool arboreal lizard with a very long prehensile tail, which prehensile means they can use their tail to grab onto stuff. Snakes have most colubrids have prehensile tails. See that she's holding on? That's prehensile tail. But theirs are fully prehensile. They have super cool emerald green. Into the next animal. And they are carnivorous. They eat a carnivore diet, feeding on crickets, mealworms, dubia roaches, if you're in the United States, and silkworms, basically any commercially found feeder that you can find pretty much anywhere. That's what they eat.
Widow face.
Look at it. Wait, they do need UVB and heat light. I would say about a 75-watt heat bulb and UVB, of course. And they are a beautiful lizard that can either be, they'll want to kill you, they'll want to get away from you, they'll want to hang out with you. So those are the three things I go by with monitors and small lizards like that. I have seen a ton that are socialized, and you can put your hand out and they'll jump out right on your hand. And I think that is just so cool because they're such a beautiful species of lizard that everybody should want. Like, why don't you want one? Like, watch a different care guide because green-keeled belly lizards are awesome. I love them. The whole head structure, their defense mechanism, sticking their tongue out is so, so cool. Number 1, my favorite lizard, and I think the best reptile that can go in an 18 by 18 by 24? You guessed it. Emerald tree skinks. I absolutely love emerald tree skinks. Their personality, their color, their diet, everything is awesome. Don't you agree? Why don't you want one? Like, they're awesome. They're so cool. And I'm getting mine in like 3 weeks, so there should be a video on that coming up. But they are a beautiful little skink. And you might be thinking, that's not a skink. Skinks have, like, they're like these guys with tiny little legs. And you're right, skinks have small little legs that they use for propulsions while slithering. They basically still slither, but they use it to go faster and slither. But these have a slender body and bigger legs to crawl around in the trees. Why would they need a sausage body crawling around trees? I'm not saying anything offensive to you, but you do have a pretty sausagey body. No, you don't have sausage. You have more of a pepperoni. But they are, like, such beautiful lizards. They eat, like, Pangaea diet and Rapashi. They also do eat crickets. They need crickets. And they are so sociable, and I absolutely love them. Heat, UVB, and they are from the Solomon Islands. You can also find them in the Philippines, too, and Thailand, and all that kind of stuff. But they are beautiful lizards, and I love them so much. That's it about my ranting, and that's it about the video. I absolutely love all these animals on this list, and do not look at my hand like that. They are such cool animals, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you like the, like, 18 by 18 by 24 kind of videos. I'm going to do maybe an 18 by 18 by 18, 36 by 18 by 36, which you can put literally a dinosaur in. And, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. Tell me what you think about this video. And now, I'll leave you. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye-bye.